that's me in there, Conrad Hart. Or maybe it would be more appropriate to say that's my body, lying in a tiny shuttle. Deep in cryogenic sleep for 50 years, I've been drifting around the cosmos alone. But however infinite the universe may be in size, you cannot be alone forever. Found me. They saw my shuttle and beamed me aboard. The cryogenic cycle kept me in a deep sleep was suddenly interrupted. I came to and opened my eyes, only to realize that to my horror, I was back in the clutches of my worst enemy, the Morphs. And it didn't take them very long to decide my fate.
Resistance. captured John O'Connor's identity, I've managed to infiltrate Shadow, the rebel stronghold. The detonation device I placed in the generator guarantees our complete victory. What?
Gentlemen, welcome to Shadow, HQ of the Mandragore.
Conrad Hart, meet Sarah Smith, leader of the Resistance.
While you were adrift, the Morphs invaded our solar system. Their military capabilities were too superior. Our government leaders surrendered. But we refuse to give up, even if we are just a few. Excuse me for a second. Hello? Are you sure? Asteroid D-321.
The Resistance was formed 8 years ago by Sarah's father. The fight is becoming more costly every day. We found that our will and courage alone aren't enough. This is our struggle.
One of our top agents has uncovered Professor Bergstein's location. The Morphs have created a research lab on Asteroid D-321. We understand they're conducting top-secret experiments there.
The professor might be able to provide us with critical data on these experiments. He may be our only hope.
Your mission is to rescue Professor Bergstein and return to Shadow. The complex on D321 is divided into two sectors. We don't know which one the professor is being held in. Conrad, you take Sector 1. Good luck, gentlemen.
Mandragore, I'd like to express our deepest gratitude to you. Your courage has given mankind back the most important thing of all, freedom. We'll meet again on Shadow.
I was no longer alone. Swallowed by hyperspace, I knew that behind me, thousands of ships of all sizes would converge on Earth. Millions had fled the Morph Menace. Like fugitives, they had wandered the universe for many decades, and sometimes barely surviving in the confines of tiny shuttles. In many cases, they were separated into small groups. Convinced they were the only survivors, many times on the brink of losing all hope. They truly admired the Mandragore, because we refused to abandon the struggle and won back our freedom. As for me, I was anxious to join my comrades back on Shadow. From now on, no one would ever be alone again.
Sir, I'd like to express our deepest gratitude to you. Your courage has given mankind back the most important thing of all, freedom. We'll meet again on Shadow.
My friends, we have gathered here tonight to prepare for our most important mission yet. This will be our only opportunity to annihilate the enemy. Thanks to our new allies, we now know that the Master Brains are interconnected telepathically, forming a single, all-powerful psychic entity which we would never dare to attack directly. Our solar system is currently controlled by one of these Master Brains. This is our target. First, Conrad and I will infiltrate the Master Brain's fortress. There, we will install a distransposer. With this, we can teleport the Pyramid of the Ancients directly inside. The Ancients will then be able to connect with the Master Brain and attempt a powerful telepathic attack. Nobody knows what the outcome will be. This is our last chance.
Professor Bergstein?
Who are you?
Does the name Mandragore mean anything to you?
I'm a friend. What a relief. I never thought anyone would get through. We have to destroy this wretched place. They are going to use a new weapon to manipulate our minds. We cannot delay. I've programmed a virus in this data cube, connected to the nuclear generator, and this place goes up in flames.
Now go to the generator. There's no time to lose.